Son? Son, are you okay? There's been some sort of a accident. Are you hurt? Where's your mother? Shay! You must still be in shock. Shay, you need to snap out of it.
What?
Our ship has crashed. Your mother's still inside. We need to get her out.
My head!
Just help me out of this sand, will you?
That girl...
Who are you talking about? Never mind, I'll get myself out.
What are you?
You need to calm down, son. There's been an accident, and your mother is still trapped.
My mother? But you're... You're not... She's really...
Yes, she's really in there. And no, I'm not gonna leave her behind. We're gonna get your mom out of there.
My... Mom?
I know we haven't seen you much in person lately. It's just that I've been busy outside the ship, or, well, what I thought was a ship, in what I thought was space.
We weren't actually in space?
The point is, your mom is still inside the thing and she's not responding to my calls. Help me find a way to get back on board, will you?
Sure. Dad? Real seagulls, not made of yarn. Is that really our ship? Why does it look like a...
A monster? I don't know. I'll figure it out after we get your mother.
I wonder how my mom's doing in there. So... You're really...
Yes. I'm really trying to get back in here. I know it's on fire, but your mother's still inside.
I mean... I guess I always knew my parents were people. It's just been a while since I thought of them that way. So, if we weren't actually in space... Where were we? Greetings! I am Shay of Laruna. Curious. If I wasn't traveling through space, then why are you speaking in an alien tongue? Judging by your outfit, I assume you're the leader of this place? I'd love to talk more, but I need to go help my parents right now. Nice schematic. This guy really seems to like schematics. Real seagulls, not made of- So, if this isn't an alien planet, why do you talk so funny? Huh. Must be some sort of performer. A clown, perhaps. Hi, I'm Shay.
I'm Carl. No, wait. You know what? Carol. My name is Carol.
Nice to meet you, Carol. Did you see that big thing crash down out there on the beach?
Mogchathra? Yeah, good riddance. Don't have to worry about that pain in the neck showing up and eating our girls anymore, I guess.
Did you say Mogchathra ate girls? Are you sure he wasn't rescuing them?
Rescuing? From what? Their loving families?
What are you doing?
Taking a break from the husband, the kids, and that darn cloud we live on. Trying to enjoy a little fishing here, but having some setbacks.
You lived on a cloud?
Yeah, but it's not as nice as it sounds. Trapped up in that fluffy, soft world, never able to leave or do anything real.
I can relate, actually. Fish aren't biting?
No. Some nitwit stole every hook in town. Trying to twist this wire into a hook, but it's not working out.
Did you say you had wire?
I have a bunch, but I'm using it all up trying to make these dang hooks.
Well, good luck and good fishing, Carol.
Worst day fishing beats the best day in a cloud cult.
I wonder if these things are dangerous.
Ugh, what's that smell?
Wow. This stinky, gross mess would never be allowed on the Bassa Nostra.
I love it.
Wow. Hey, it's one of my Hexapal buddies. Doesn't look like he survived getting thrown off the ship. Poor guy. Doesn't look like he survived getting thrown off the ship. Poor guy. Wow. Looks like something really hot happened here. I guess that's a volcano. They look so different in the ship's cosmognopedia. What the?
That outfit.
Operation Dandelion.
Are you
me from the future?
Are you me from the past?
I can't believe what I'm seeing.
This is amazing. I'm not sure the world is ready for two of us.
Yeah, our parents would probably agree. One Shay is enough.
Yeah. Wait, who's Shay?
We're Shay.
My name is Alex. I don't remember ever being called Shay.
You didn't grow up on the Bassa Nostra?
No, I grew up on the Malaruna.
Oh, then we're not...
Yeah, I guess not.
That's a relief.
Yeah. Wait, why is that a relief?
Nothing. I just mean that... Nothing. So, why are you dressed like me?
Were you also in Operation Dandelion?
Yeah, what I thought was a spaceship. But then, it crashed, and it wasn't in space. And there was this angry girl there, and my ship looked like a monster on the outside.
You know, I remember the Malaruna looked a little funny after the crash, but I just thought it was deflated airbags and fire damage. Well, if I wasn't actually from space, that will make my trip back to Laruna a lot easier. If I can get this ship fixed.
You're going back to Laruna? That's where I'm from. But they said it was dying.
Yeah, well, if they lied to us about the space thing, who knows what else they're lying about?
Have you seen Laruna? What's it like?
No idea. I was born on this ship, and my parents never showed me any pictures. But supposedly, it's dying.
So, why do you want to get back there?
Dying or not, Home sounds pretty good after 300 years stuck on a sandcastle.
How are you going to get this ship back to Laruna?
Well, if I can get my space conductor up and working again, he'll take me back to a previous destination, as long as I compose the right tune into his nav song.
Nav song? You mean your nav scarf?
Nav scarf? Was your mom really into knitting or something? Mine was all about music. Everything we did on my ship was about music. Just between you and me, I'm a little sick of the music thing.
Where are your parents?
They lived for about 20 years after the crash, and then passed away 3 months apart from each other. That's one of the reasons I went into chrysolation. But hey, maybe if I get back to Laruna, who knows, I might have some other family there.
My ship crashed down on the beach. Didn't you see it?
Oh, that was your ship.
Yeah, why?
Well, I might have actually shot it down.
What? Why?
Well, this girl, Vela, wanted to kill the monster, Mog Chothra. And I kind of owed her one.
Mog Chothra. Why did they put us on spaceships that weren't spaceships?
Well, we were supposed to be looking for a new place to live. But maybe we were actually looking for something else and we just didn't know it.
Did you have a strange wolf on your ship who told you to hack the controls?
Weird. I did get hacking ideas like that, but I'm too embarrassed to say where they came from.
Come on. Tell me where you got the idea to hack the ship.
I started hallucinating that my cello was talking to me. It would walk around and talk and tell me to keep secrets from my mom.
Did your cello have a name?
Well, he called himself Merrick.
Huh?
But you know I just made that up.
No. I had a Merrick too. He wanted us to rescue. Or capture. Girls.
Those helpless creatures were... Oh, man. I'm kind of glad I never managed to rescue any now.
Do you need any help getting your ship running?
Do I ever. Looters have taken some critical parts.
Well, maybe we have some extra parts on my ship. It's just downstairs on the beach.
Shay, our ship, it came to life and flew away. Probably to Laruna on autopilot.
Oh no. Is that me from the past?
No, Dad. This is Alex. He was in Operation Dandelion years ago.
Ray Volta, pleasure to meet you.
His ship crashed here too, and now he wants to go back to Laruna.
Well, I'll be. We're inside a Diamond Age Dandelion cruiser. Never seen one in person before.
If we can get my ship running, you're welcome to come back with me and look for your ship in Laruna.
Son, I think you've just found a way to catch up to your mother. I can whip up a batch of my special hull patching compound. Would that help?
Sure would. I'll bet the undercarriage on this baby is shot.
Leave it to me. I saw a tub with some good starter enzymes down on the beach.
Yeah, so that's my dad.
Cool.
So, what else does your ship need to fly?
Let me see here. Still need an electronics genius, and, still need your dad to patch the holes in the hull. What else? I still need a radiation suit. Haven't found a superconductive gyroscopic hypercam yet. And gotta replace my heavy-duty anti-gravity thrust unit. Once we take care of that, we'll be ready to fly.
On it. Who do you think has been looting your ship?
Actually, I suspect the guards outside. Something about their outfits.
There aren't any guards out there.
Walked off the job, eh? Man, 300 years ago, people were a lot more professional, I'll tell you what.
What was it about your guards' outfits that made you suspicious?
Did they look like they were hiding loot underneath?
No, it was the way they were made from the same material as my radiation shielding blast curtains.
Oh.
What's a superconductive gyro what's it can?
A superconductive gyroscopic hypercam. A small but critical part of the ship's controls. Here, I'll draw you a detailed schematic.
Okay, I'll see if I can find one lying around. So, what kind of help do you need with the wiring?
I need an electrical genius who can get into small spaces, knows how to solder, and who can memorize circuit boards at a glance.
Okay, yeah, that's not me. I'll find somebody. Okay, see you later.
Okay.
What's this? It looks so familiar.
Alex drew this schematic for a superconductive gyroscopic hypercam.
Now, if I just knew what to do with it.
Hey, you got this old-timey laser coil and amplifying quartz all hooked up wrong. Want me to...
No, don't touch them. They've come close to overheating several times, and they're extremely unstable. I'll get around to fixing that soon. Just leave it to me.
All right. Hey, you got this old-timey laser coil. Not sure what this strange diamond-shaped socket is for. It's not exactly the same shape, but maybe if I turn it... Oh, that doesn't look good. This button only works on grabbing Gary.
I wonder where he is now. And what he's grabbing. So strange. But I feel like I've seen this pyramid before.
And I don't just mean a minute ago, when I was walking in. I mean, like, in a dream, almost.
Target acquired. Just gotta line up the shot. Almost got it. Hold still. Death from above! Ah, rats! I thought I had that one.
Were you trying to stab me? Why?
Don't take it personally, kid. It's just what I do. For instance, just a minute ago, I took down this whole ship. After ripping the very fabric of space itself. So you got off easy.
Just when I thought things couldn't get any stranger.
I knew you'd be back. Something tells me you're a girl who knows the value of a good knife.
Can I just confirm that you are a talking knife? because I'm trying to figure out if I'm losing my mind or just mildly hallucinating.
Oh, I'm the real deal, kid. I think the logical marvel and sharp, too.
What are you doing inside the monster, Mob Chothra?
Monster? Kid, you are inside the spaceship Bossa Nostra. Or, just outside of it, actually.
We're outside of a spaceship? Then how can I breathe?
Don't ask me. I'm solid state. I gotta admit, though, this ship and everything around it has been acting a little nutty since I cut it. But that's to be expected.
Who's the captain of this ship?
Well, the other kid who just tumbled through that bright spot in space, that's the one we called Commander. But the real brains of the operation, we just called Mom.
Where can I find Mom?
Beats me. I haven't heard from her in a while. But hey, I didn't stab her. You can't pin that on me.
You're coming with me. And for the record, I took down this ship.
Whatever. Ride's a ride.
I can still see the sky through that hole in space. Weird. A good knife is handy to have around, even when it is kind of a creep.
Attention, current altitude below recommended level. Outer hull breach detected. Attempting emergency takeoff. Warning, ship off axis. Gyro stabilizers offline. Anti-gravity field unavailable during hull breach.
Looks like this thing took some damage from me. Nothing seems to be going in or out of these. Nothing seems to be going in or out of these. These pipes are just as busted as the others. Nothing seems to be going in or out of these. Nothing seems to be going in or out of these.
Initializing starfield repair.
What is that? A goldfish bowl? Oh. I guess space helmet makes more sense.
Matrix cleared. Depleting starfield repair. Starfield integrity restored. Initializing repressurization. Function unavailable. Air transport system incomplete. Unable to repressurize. Unable to engage anti-gravity field. Air transport system incomplete. Unable to repressurize.
Not sure if the space helmet is going to be much use, seeing that we're not really in space. Open up! Dang, not opening. Hey, Pointy, you actually any good at cutting stuff?
The name's Dutch, and the answer's yes. Yes, yes, yes! Finally. Thanks for that.
Thank you.
I think this is the beginning of a beautiful friendship.
I could get a longer hose by cutting it up here, but then I don't think I'd survive the fall.
Come on, I bet 50% of us would survive.
There's a weak point on that hose, but I can't reach it from here. A good knife is handy to have around, even when it is kind of a creep. I might be able to make a connection with this little hose, but which one? Can't reach the other pipes with this short hose. I might be able to make...
Accessing maintenance panel 22.
I was hoping for something more spectacular. They call it a maintenance panel. There's a weak point on that hose, but I can't reach it from here. Nothing up here either. Okay, and pop this on there. Let's see what that does.
Accessing maintenance panel 36.
Well, now what?
Air transport system incomplete. Unable to repressurize.
There's a weak point on that hose. I have a good feeling about that pipe.
Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yuck. Can't reach the other pipes with this short hose. But which one? This one? Looks as good as any. Now what?
Accessing maintenance panel 114.
Okay. But is that good or bad? That goes...
Warning, unanticipated hydraulic connection.
Well, now what?
Warning, fluid detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good.
Accessing maintenance panel 114.
Okay. But is that good or bad? I can't reach that platform. I could get a longer hose by cutting it off. I'll bet that hatch is my way out of here. To this one. Worth a shot.
Warning, unanticipated hydraulic connection.
Well, now what?
Warning, fluid detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good. Pop this on...
Accessing maintenance panel 36.
To here. Why not?
Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yuck.
Accessing maintenance panel 22.
I'll attach this in...
Warning, unanticipated hydraulic connection.
Well, now what?
Warning, fluid detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good. When you find a pair of shoes that fit, hang on to them. That's what I say. A good knife is handy to have around, even when it is kind of a creep. They're already cut. I don't need cloud shoes here. It's the trigger to Alex's death ray. Not opening. The voice is making me think it has something to do with pressurization. The announcer voice. Not some voice in my head, I mean.
Whatever.
Hey, Pointy. Think you could open that hatch?
My name is Dutch.
Okay, Dutch. Do you?
No.
Weird smell coming out of this one. This one could be important. Or not. No idea what this one is for. I hope that gas coming out isn't flammable. Can't reach the other pipes with this.
Warning, unanticipated hydraulic connection.
At least nothing blew up.
Accessing maintenance panel 114.
Huh.
Warning, fluid detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good. Other end goes here? Maybe.
Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yuck. Okay, this one.
Accessing maintenance panel 36.
Hmm.
Accessing maintenance panel 22.
At least nothing blew up.
Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yuck. Weird smell coming out of this one.
Air transport system incomplete.
I don't think that's the right spot to make a connection. Okay, that should do something good.
Accessing maintenance panel 114.
Okay, but is that good? Bad. No idea what this one is for.
Warning, fluid detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good. Okay, this one's got to be the air supply. Or is it sewage? No idea what this one is for. This one could be important. This pipe goes.
Accessing maintenance panel 114. Warning, unanticipated hydraulic connection.
I was hoping for something more. I can't make any new connections with this helmet. I can't figure out a way to put them together.
Come on, I bet 50% of us would survive.
No idea what this one is.
Warning, coolant detected in air supply.
That doesn't sound good.
Accessing maintenance panel.
I could get a longer hose by cutting it up here, but I can't reach that platform.
Air transport system incomplete. Unable to repressurize. Warning, air venting into suit. Accessing maintenance panel 36. Air transport system incomplete.
Well, who wants to live forever, right?
I'm really starting to like you, kid.
How? That hurt, but it was worth it for this hose, I think.
Cutting is always worth it.
I want to keep it long so I can connect things that are far apart.
Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yeah.
Accessing maintenance panel 36.
I'll hook this hose. Can't reach the other pipes with this short hose. Hopefully I can make some new connect. Let's hook this pipe. Can't reach the other pipes with this short hose. Now that's a hose. Hopefully I can make some new connections with this long hose. Can't reach the other pipes with this. Should be able to make some sort. Now that's a hose. Hopefully I can make some new connections with this long hose. Weird smell coming out of this one. This one could be important. Or not. What's this one do? Hopefully I can make some new connections with this long hose. Hopefully I can make some new... This one could be important. Or not. Okay, this one's got to be the air supply. Or is it sewage? No idea what this one is for. I might be able to make a connection with this little hose, but which one?
Accessing maintenance panel 36. Warning, air venting into sewage overflow.
Yeah. Hopefully I can make some new connections with this long hose. Okay, this one's got to be the air supply. Hopefully I can make some new connections with this long hose.
Air transport system integrity restored.
Oh, yeah.
Beginning repressurization.
Wait, that's good, right?
Engaging anti-gravity field.
Oh, here we go.
Gyro stabilizers online.
Is the room spinning, or is it me? There's the hatch. Aw, I missed it. Yikes, what's that claw thing? And that claw thing. I wonder if that looks... Oh! Like boots. wonder if that little claw is getting at that creepy giant robot hand feels oddly familiar to me. Come on! Stupid physics. Can't get anywhere. Reach that arm if I held you out?
I could stab it, but I can't grab it.
Yeah, but it might grab you.
Nah, it only grabs the boy and his stuff. Mom's arms are funny that way.
Oh. It's right here, Wats. Bad timing. Grab it, Wats. Bad timing. Claw, Wats. Bad timing. I know you want this helmet. You got me. Now let go of that helmet. Something tells me I'm not going to be able to get you to let go of that boot, am I? Wow, Yarn Arm is definitely not letting go of that boot. What's so special about that boot, huh? I feel like I shouldn't do that. Still not long enough. Looks like the arm has found something. It's not sure if this space helmet is going to be much use, seeing that we're not... Dang. Bad timing. Whoa! Hey, I recognize that grip. I'll bet you were inside one of those tentacles that grabbed me on the beach. Probably one of the ones I shot, I'm guessing. Well, serves you right. I don't need to wear it. I don't want to fly out that way. I don't want to fly. I can't reach that boot. Probably not. Maybe I can push off this thing. Woohoo! Space!
I did it!
Oh, come on. That's better. The air was starting to get a little thin out there.
Oh, ship. It's really gone. Hey, where did all the seashells go?
Alex drew this schematic for a superconductive gyroscopic hypercam.
Now, if I just knew what to do with it.
Hey. Do you think you could help me make a superconductive gyroscopic hypercam?
That looks like a... Yes. Yes, if I weren't choking. Okay.
He doesn't want to see my baby clothes. Need a hook?
Sure do. Look, kid. That's a nice hook, but I'm not fishing for minnows, you know.
What? This is a great hook. I'll prove it to you.
Sure, kid.
Wow, that smell kind of makes me miss the fish guts.
I added noxious odors to the recipe when you were a baby to keep you from eating that stuff.
Dad?
Son?
At least now we have a plan. Right, Dad?
Well, half of one at least. If our ship's headed to Laruna on autopilot, and if we can fix Alex's ship and hitch a ride there with him, then all we have to figure out is...
what to do when we get there.
Right.
What's cooking?
Found some fermented biomatter here. Perfect enzymatic base for my patented hull patch formula. Only problem is, I can't add the bonding agent until I know I have the pH balanced perfectly, or the whole batch will be ruined.
I wish I could do more to help Alex fix his ship.
Well, what's still left to do?
Do you know where we can get a heavy-duty anti-gravity thrust unit?
No, but those are pretty big. If there's one around, you should be able to see it. Unless someone were hiding it.
Do you have an extra radiation suit?
I'd give you the shirt off my back, son. But it doesn't block radiation, I'm afraid.
You're good with electronics, right?
Well, the ship used to fix its own wiring using robots. So I never needed to learn how, unfortunately.
Can you build a superconductive gyroscopic hypercam?
Sure. Just ask the ship's replicators to... oh, yeah. Well, maybe someone here knows how.
Do you have any wire?
All my tools are still on the ship.
Don't worry, Dad. I've got this under control.
That's my boy.
Dad, did you know we weren't in space the whole time?
No, but I had my suspicions. In my nightly maintenance patrols of the ship's exterior, I found many anomalies I couldn't explain.
Was Operation Dandelion for real?
Obviously, Operation Dandelion was not what they told us it was. But why hide it from us? What were they up to?
Did you and Mom know about Merrick?
Who?
The guy in the wolf suit, who lived in the vents of the ship.
If there were someone on the ship without our knowledge, that could only be the work of the Thrushmaster, the head of Operation Dandelion. But why send an operative and not tell us?
How's the hull patch coming?
Great. Except I can't add the final ingredient until I know I have the pH balanced correctly.
Can't you just do a taste test or something?
My taste buds aren't that sensitive. Also, I put poison in there.
What?
Well, it's usually to keep space parasites from chewing on the patch. Force of habit, I guess.
How would you change the pH anyway?
I've added all the calcium carbonate I could get my hands on, just to lower the acidity and raise the pH to be... somewhere in the ballpark. But I need to know it's exactly 7 before I put in the final ingredient.
How'd you get the calcium carbonate?
By grinding up every seashell on the beach. But I fear it's still not enough.
Where can I get more calcium carbonate?
That's a great question. If I could find just one more shell, that would help.
Good luck, Dad.
Mm-hmm.
It's gone. Nothing down there now but sand.
This hook may look small, but it's made from really advanced materials. You could catch a whale with this thing.
Mm-hmm. Prove it.
Hey, Carol.
Oh, that's so nice to hear.
Where did Mog Chothra go?
Yeah, that was weird. Guess he wasn't dead after all. He just up and flew out of here. Probably headed back home with his tail between his legs.
Where is Mog Chothra's home?
They say he comes from over the Plague Dam. Must be some Mama Mog over there popping out fresh monsters every 14 years or so.
Hey, do you know anything about electronics?
Oh, no. I only work with wire to reinforce the cloud shoes I make. Correction, used to make.
Well, good luck and good fishing, Carol.
Ciao!
It's gone. Nothing down there now but sand.
Filthy, lousy, sadistic... Oops.
I heard you talking. You don't need to hide it from me.
Talking to humans hasn't really worked out well for me.
Don't worry. I've seen much weirder stuff than talking trees where I'm from.
Oh, so I'm a weird thing, huh? A freak? Does that make you want to cut me down, huh? Turn me into a stool, I suppose?
No, that's not what I was saying at all. I understand why you're mad. Stuck in one place all your life, wanting to see the world.
No, that's not what's making me upset. It's all the murderous humans who want to cut us down. Being stuck in one spot is kind of like the whole tree thing, man. Who wouldn't like that?
Do all trees talk in this land?
Maybe take the time to talk to them before you cut them down, and you'll find out.
I've never cut down a tree in my life.
Really? How'd you get your wood?
We didn't use wood. My mom just knit everything we needed.
Well, that's just the sweetest thing I've ever... Wait. What were her knitting needles made of?
Plastic.
Okay.
I think... Do you know anything about fixing spaceships?
No, that's a subject that never resonated with me.
Oh, good one.
Yeah, tree jokes are the best.
Have you seen a mad-looking girl in a tattered dress?
Oh, please don't mention that demented little urchin to me. It makes me sick to think of how she made me sick.
Why did she make you sick?
She coveted my sap. I saw her collect it in a bucket. Oh, curse my precious fluids and all their magical hardening properties.
Ha. Well, I gotta make like a tree and split.
It's supposed to be a banana, but don't worry about it. Tree jokes are hard.
I've detected an unusual rock formation on the surface.
That's not rock. It's the hardened shell of my sick, summoned from my gut by a banshee in a shredded gown.
You don't say. Never seen one of those before.
Nah. Don't see anything there I want to eat.
Any talking trees over here? No?
Good.
I can hear you.
That's an interesting smell. So unfamiliar.
What the? Oh, wow. This is incredible. A real giant constrictor. My mother never would have allowed this. That must have been danger I was throwing. Feel like letting go of me, Mr. Huggy? Wow. Oh, you really aren't kidding around. I hate to do this to you, big guy, but... I've got stuff to do. No time for play right now.
There's some sort of flyer in here.
Hey, this is that girl that tried to punch me.
Please contact the Tartine family in Sugar Bunting if you have any information about our beloved daughter. How do I break it to them that their daughter was swallowed by my spaceship? Definitely leave out the part about it being my spaceship, for starters. I want to tell these people that I've seen their daughter, but I'm not ready to answer all the questions they'll surely have.
Sorry, wood shop is closed. No more stools. Come back late.
Whoa. Never seen an outfit like that before. Where'd you get it?
Space.
Uh-huh. Hey, I get it. You don't want to reveal your source. Have everybody biting your style next week.
Biting my...
It's cool. I got my own thing, so...
Hi, my name's Shay.
Curtis.
What are you making there?
Art. Forged from metal. I used to work with wood, but, you know, it was getting all trendy, and the tree started talking, and there was no money in it, so I got into metal.
How long have you been into metal?
Oh, I've been into metal for, like, ever. But my kid just arrived today, so I've been, like, hardcore for about 6 hours.
What are you forging?
Well, in fact, you are the lucky one to see my very first collectible die-cast miniature.
Oh. That's so cool.
Well, the catalog said it was supposed to be a wizard. But it looks more like a kitten reading a book. Dang it, did I order the wrong mold?
You order your molds from a catalog?
Hey, I'm just starting out, okay? It's like I'm in the cover band phase. I want to do my own material, like, eventually.
Do you have any other molds?
I could only afford this one. The idea was to sell a bunch of wizards to buy more molds, but this stupid cat? I don't know if I'm ever going to get a new mold.
What is that big ladder go on your roof?
There's a ladder on my roof?
More like through your roof.
Not sure. But I've got a hunch that Vela had something to do with it.
Is Vela a friend of yours?
Well, she used to come around here a lot. Had a thing for my stools.
Think you could make me a radiation suit?
Nah, I don't do soft goods. If you're looking for a good seamstress, though, I'd check out Mariloft. They do amazing stuff with feathers. You know, if you're into that kind of thing.
Well, have fun with the metal.
Later, Shader.
Home metallurgy kit. make money without leaving your home.
That's the new plan, man. I'm cashing in, selling out. Just until I get some money saved, of course. You know, then I'm gonna go right back to doing that whole integrity thing.
Home metallurgy kit. Make... Well, have fun with the metal. Is this boarded up for fire safety or something?
Yeah, safety. Never know when an inspector's gonna show up. Dude, don't burn trash in my house, please.
Your paintings are all ripped up.
Yeah, that was a different me who did that. I'm much more calm now that I'm working with metal.
Hey, if I gave you a crochet hook, could you make something interesting out of it?
No, I never learned how to crochet. But maybe if this whole die-cast figurine thing doesn't work out.
I don't think that would help me get this hypercam made. Hey, can you fix tiny robots?
No, but I could make you a new one if I had the mold. Also, it would be kind of on the statue end of the robot spectrum.
This button only works on grabbing Gary. I wonder where he is now, and what he's grabbing. There's a piece missing from this window.
Oh, yeah. I lost the sun somehow.
Yeah, me too. Phew, now that was a ladder. Whoa, check out these crazy clouds.
I'm either in some sort of hallway, or else it's the creature's esophagus. Warning. Airlock ahead. Safety suit and air tether required for extravehicular exploration. But don't worry, I'll put it on you, sweetie pie. So, those spacesuit parts I found belong to someone named Sweetie Pie. But who is behind Sweetie Pie? That's what I want to know. We're moving. That means I brought Malkchothra back to life. Are you another prisoner of Malkchothra? Must be a maiden from some land of hexagons. Don't worry, little Hexagal. I'm gonna find all the other maidens and get us all out of here, okay? We're moving pretty fast. That's going to start a fire. Warning. Objects placed into this trash chute will be jettisoned from the ship. Is that a train? This door doesn't open. Man, this place is a mess. Mog Chothra may be alive again, but he doesn't look so hot. Looks like something horrible is in here. But what? Door won't open. Think you can pry this door open, Dutch?
Sorry. Once they're locked, only Mom can open them. She's the brain of the operation.
The brain, eh? Can you take me to her?
I'll tell you this. You're getting warmer.
I wish I knew how to fix that. So much junk in here. This must be the room where they melt stuff. Oh, must be locked or something. Belly of the beast. Or ship. Either way, monster or machine, I took it down before. Should be even easier from the inside. Is this the brain? Looks important, but also super fake. Must be a decoy. This place is falling apart. Locked. Wow. We're pretty high up. Hello in there.
Who's out there? I can barely hear you.
My name is Bella Tartine, and I'm here to take you down.
Did you say Martine? Shay, is that you making a joke?
Engineering department. Just a routine maintenance visit.
Engineering department? What are you talking about? Is that you, Shay?
The ship's on fire. You have to get out of there.
I know the ship's on fire, that's why I'm staying put in this fireproof room until I figure out what to do. Who is this?
All clear. It's safe to come out now.
Safe? Who are you kidding?
Is this Mog Chothra's brain?
Log off the train? I've lost all contact with the train.
Can you open this door?
I could, but I won't. Not until I know who you are.
It's me, Shay!
Really? Is that really you, Shay? You sound so strange.
I I was injured. It's affecting my voice.
Oh, that sounds terrible. If it's true, oh, I just don't know what to believe.
It's me. Don't you recognize me?
Well, not really, to tell you the truth.
If you don't believe I'm Shay, I'm leaving.
Oh, I just don't know what to believe right now. My son would understand that. Maybe.
What's this? Some sort of living quarters? Oh, quit with the sad stuff, Mogchathra. You brought this on yourself. Gruesome. Wait, is that real? That looks pretty heavy. Okay, that's definitely fake. Whew. That looks pretty heavy. Nice view. Both of them. Huh. Someone pried open this vent. I wonder why. Guess there's only one way to find out.
Shay! You. It's you. The last one.
Who are you? Are you in control of this monster ship?
No. She is in control. The brains. I was just a stowaway sent to save the young boy.
What were you saving the boy from?
From her. The one they call Mom. She's been programmed to keep the boy safe, but she's taken it beyond sanity or reason. Now he is her prisoner. We all are.
Who's her? I mean, who is she?
She's the brains of this ship. You can find her in the room next to the galley. But be careful. She has eyes and hands everywhere.
Why did you call me the last one?
You were the last creature, final subject of our rescue mission. Shay seemed especially interested in you on more than one occasion.
Why did you single me out?
I assume he sensed your strength somehow, your spirit. I hope he was right.
Is the boy the one kidnapping maidens?
No. And yes, he made the selections but didn't know what he was selecting. He thought he was rescuing helpless creatures because that's really what we were doing.
How were you rescuing anyone?
We were saving you from the plague.
What plague?
Get me out of here and I'll explain.
Why did you have the boy select whom you were rescuing?
Even our best technology is no match for the instincts of a boy like Shay, especially at his age.
You're not really explaining anything.
It's hard for me to talk. Get this off of me and I can explain everything.
Where are the other maidens you rescued?
They're safe, but locked up. Once we get control of the ship back from her, we can free them.
Where is this ship headed?
I assume back to its homeland to deliver us to its masters.
The boy's not a prisoner anymore. He escaped when I, boarded.
I see. Well, that shouldn't affect the mission.
Which mission?
To get control of this ship and end this madness.
Can we stop this ship?
Yes, but only if we can get into the central control room. She's locked the door with some sort of manual override. It can only be opened by her, from the inside.
Can you open any of the locked doors on the ship?
Well, my arms are pinned, but I think I can push this one button. That's the best I can do.
Thanks. I can work with that. Hey, wait, you're a wolf. Sorry, I've had a really strange day, and it's getting hard to recognize strange things right away.
It's a long story, but I promise if you help me get out of here, I'll explain everything.
I've gotta go.
Get into the central control room. It's the only way to stop this.
That's the switch he used to unlock that door over there. Better leave it unlocked. I don't want to free this guy until I'm 100% sure about him. This door is locked. I wonder what they keep in here. Looks like some sort of animal sleeps here. Looks like a museum in here, after a tornado. Wonder if I can learn something about that kid in here. Looks like some sort of medical report. Metabot exam report. Patient continues normal, healthy development. Unlike his first 5 years, this year has been marked by a remarkable growth spurt. In 1 year, he has grown 2 inches taller and gained 3 shoe sizes. Splark therapy appears to be working. Splark? Shay Volta, best actor, Purple Boots, the musical. Looks like a note written by a little kid. Dear Shoe Fairy, thanks for the shoes. Aw, the red striped ones were cool, and so were the green ones with skulls. But next year, could I please have red shoes with skulls? Please, please, please. Thanks, Shay. Sheesh, demanding. What a sad sack. It says, Safety Award, Footwear Category. Second place, Shoe Tying Contest. It's a painting of what looks like a red boot. It's a painting of what looks like a red boot. Shay's first space boots, age 5. Shay's first space boots, age 5. I don't want to cut that.
Only because you haven't tried.
That train wreck looks like ominous foreshadowing to me. Shay's first space boots, age 5. I wonder if he lost his first teeth by licking a moving beater, like I did. I'll give this guy one excuse. He had a weird childhood. I'll bet someone was trying to knit socks and they ended up too long. And so, snake. Shay's first space boots, age 5. I wonder if he lost his first teeth by licking a moving beater, like I did. That is the happiest snake attack victim I've ever seen. Hello?
Hey, who are you?
My name's Vella. What's yours?
Mine? Well, mine is, gosh, it's been so long since anyone asked. Let me look it up. It's Melanie, huh?
Are you a closet, Melanie?
Kind of. Step inside. I'll show you. Good. Now close those eyes tight to make sure your eyeballs make it to the same place you do.
What?
Close your eyes and don't look down. Surprise! I'm a teleporter. Now you tell me a secret.
Hey, where'd the other room go? What's wrong with my head? And my voice?
Oh, no, I thought I had that fixed.
You made my head bigger.
Don't worry, sweetie, it's temporary. Take a trip back through me and I'll set things right.
This is weird. Hello?
You know, she hasn't said much since the ship was attacked. Hope she's okay. She's just being a drama queen, so she'll get special maintenance. Give it up, Nadine!
Still out of commission? Guess so. Hi.
Who wants to go to the starboard passageway? Let's see if this works. Bye-bye.
Ah, there's my old head again.
Are you sure? It still looks a little big to me.
Yes, this is all brains.
All right, all right.
Warning. Objects placed into this trash chute will be jettisoned from the ship. Doors. Locked. Hello in there.
Who's out there? I can barely hear you.
It's me, Shay.
You sound so strange.
Okay, I'm not really Shay.
What? Are you playing some kind of cruel joke on me?
If you don't believe I'm Shay, I'm leaving.
Oh, I just don't know what to believe right now. My son would understand that. Maybe.
Hello in there.
Who's out there?
It's me, Shay! If you don't believe I'm Shay...
I don't think this helps. Hello in there.
Who's out there?
It's me. If you don't believe...
looks like some sort of video game. That looks pretty heavy. Gruesome. Wait, is that real? Cut that. I can't break up that debris with this knife. That looks pretty heavy. Nice view. Both of them. Still out of commission? Guess so. See? We're not in space, Dutch.
I knew that. I'm the one that took this ship down, you remember?
No, I'm the one that took it down. But let's not fight. Let's team up and take it down again together.
As long as it involves me cutting stuff, I'm in.
I don't want to cut that. This place is falling apart. This must be the room where they melt stuff. I might need them. I don't want to throw them off the ship. Are you another prisoner of... Doesn't seem to be any way back up there, but you know... That's okay. I like having my feet on the ground. Someone ought to fix that. Hey there.
Back to the roof. It's so nice to de-risk new people.
You made my head. Hi, Mel.
Back to the junk room. Close your eyes and don't look down.
Ah, there's my old head again. Safety award, aquatics category. Shay's first space boots, age 5. I'll give this guy one excuse. He had a weird childhood. is the hap... Looks like some sort of animal sleeps here. This door is locked. I don't want to cut that. That's the switch he used to unlock that door. I've got to go.
Get into the central control.
Looks like some sort of video game. The only thing this trigger is good for is firing Alex's death ray. And only when we're in range and I have a clear shot. Oh, quit with the sad stuff, Mogchathra. You brought this on yourself. Gruesome. Wait, is that real? I'm keeping these to myself. If the only thing this trigger is, that looks pretty heavy. Hello in there.
It's me. If you don't believe...
We're going so fast. Locked. Seriously, who do they think they're fooling with this baby stuff? I don't want to cut that. I don't think this helmet would do much good there. No way am I touching that. I'd get electrocuted. Locked, maybe. If I could find the brains of this operation, I could open all these doors. See? We're not in space, Dutch.
I knew.
This must be the room where they melt stuff. Oh, must be locked or something. Yeah, better put this back to cover my tracks. I don't want to cut that. Someone ought to fix that. I don't think this helmet would do much good there. Looks like something horrible is in here. But what? Door won't open. This door doesn't open. That's going to start a fire. Warning. Objects placed into this trash chute will be jettisoned from the ship. It doesn't have a head. Or it's all head. I can't tell. Warning. Airlock. I don't want to cut that.
Okay, for there, you're doing great. You built the new ladder. You got it attached, just like I asked. Now all you have to do is climb up here and rescue me.
Brother Lightbeard, can you not climb down yourself?
I've told you a million times for there. I've been up here too long. My feet are weak. They're like little teacups. I dare not use them. Now please, for there, stop wasting time.
I can't, Brother Lightbeard. You know, I...
No, don't cry, whatever you do.
I can't.
Ah, brother.
Mind if I try your ladder?
You will help me rescue Brother Lightbeard?
I'll see what I can do.
That's very light of you. Thank you.
See? Nothing to be afraid of. Wait a second. What's happening?
Darn it. He looked so light.
Help?
A little farther for there.
It's not me.
Heart of gold, but he never takes anything 100%, you know?
How does that big cloud stay afloat?
Just like all the other clouds. There's nothing special about my cloud.
Why don't you just climb down?
My legs have atrophied from lack of use.
Wow. How long have you been up there?
Just since this morning. By atrophied, I just mean really, really stiff.
Why don't you just stay up there?
I need to get back to my cloud house before tea time. If the watercress sandwiches stay out too long, the bread gets a tough outer layer. Almost like a new crust, you know? And then Chef has to make new ones. It's just really not fair to him.
I'm trying to get up there, but I can't reach.
Don't you have something you could stand on?
Any idea where I can find a heavy-duty anti-gravity thrust unit?
Hey, whoa! What are you implying? I'm naturally buoyant.
I just meant you seem to know a lot about lift.
Please, my lightness comes from within.
Okay, see you later. How does that big cloud stay afloat?
Just like all...
Okay, see you later.
Aren't you gonna figure out how to get me down?
I can't do that from here.
Hey, I'm still up here.
Fither!
Hello?
Can you rescue Harm me now?
I still can't reach him, and he's too noble to jump.
Go get help.
I can't leave Brother Lightbeard's side, or his underneath, or whatever.
Can you untie that bow on Harm-Knee's cloud?
Why would I do that?
So we can use it to make a rescue harness for him.
Great idea! So, how do I untie it?
Can you tell me what kind of knot it is?
Yeah, the big old nasty looking kind.
Thanks. I'm sure it looks harder than it is. Let's give it a shot.
I'll try.
Try to find a loose section.
Like this? I don't think that was right.
What does it look like now?
Well, like a whole new terrible knot.
Father.
Hello?
Father, could you try to describe that knot to me?
I don't think so. Really.
Let's give that knot another try, okay?
Okay.
Try wiggling it.
Huh? All right. Now it's even more naughty.
What does it look like now?
Well, like a whole new terrible knot.
Aren't you gonna figure out
I can't
how to
do
get
that
me down?
From here. Hey, what's wrong, big guy?
Brother Lightbeard needs my help, but I have failed him. Also, I don't like being called big.
Hi, I'm Shay. What's your name?
They used to call me Fathur, but after this day, they will only call me Coward, or maybe, if I'm lucky, Coward.
Who's Brother Lightbeard?
Our benevolent leader who was stranded on his high cloud when a strange girl broke his ladder.
Tell me more about this strange girl.
She looked so light, but I sensed a heaviness in her heart. Sure enough, when she got on the ladder, it broke. I think Harmony's teachings really could have helped her.
Any idea why we're able to walk on these clouds?
Because the words of Harmony Lightbeard make us light.
Any idea where I can get a heavy-duty anti-gravity thrust unit?
Oh, I'm sure we don't have one of those. Harmony hates anything heavy.
Well, see you later. Don't give up. Looks like it's hatching season.
But I was just trying to take care of my family.
Why don't they build a fountain for that window? Or is this some kind of warning about it? Looks like someone tied this ladder down. There's a note. Guys, quit moving my ladder, please. You're really cheesing me off. Signed, Gus. It's too bad Alex didn't say super fluffy gyroscopic hypercam, because feathers we got. My name's Shay. I'm from... out of town.
Me too. I'm from Sugar Bunting. My name's Husker. This here is Walter.
Walter.
Sticking to that, are you?
Did you say your name was Walter? Or Walt-er?
My name was lightened to Walt-er by Harmony Lightbeard.
It's not a cult thing.
It is a cult thing. No, wait! It's not a cult thing. Quit confusing me.
Oh, you mean that weird guy on that fake cloud over there?
There's nothing fake about Harmony Lightbeard or his
It has stitching holding it together and a big bow at the bottom.
Didn't you notice? It's pretty obvious.
Have you guys seen a giant monster flying by here? Some people call him Bog Chofra.
Not since he came to my village to destroy it. My daughter, Vela, fought him off. Can you believe it? She was so brave. She taught us all a lesson that day.
Your town wouldn't happen to be named Danger System 5, would it?
No, I think I mentioned I'm from Sugar Bunting.
What kind of name is Danger System 5?
Sounds like something from a kids' action program.
Ha! Yeah. Something to entertain little kids, maybe.
What's this little hut for?
It's my wife's cloud shoe business. She was working hard to make money, while I just worked on giving it away. She's run off now, and I have no idea where.
I think I might have seen your wife.
Really? Where?
Don't tell him. You know what, Walter? When she's ready to come back, she'll find you, okay?
You're right.
Well, see you guys later.
Take care, Shay.
Do you know this girl?
Oh, I see you got one of our flyers. We're spreading them all around, hoping to find out where she went after she landed here.
I told you everything I know.
Uh-oh.
Hey, hey! You want to buy a cupcake? It's a fundraiser for a good cause.
Hi, I'm Shay.
You want a cupcake, Shay?
I want a cupcake.
Great. Got any money?
No, but I support your cause.
That's great, but we need funds to pay for printing, distribution, baking, frosting. Come back when you get some real cash, okay?
What's the special cause?
We're raising money for an awareness campaign about her missing sister. And about the lies of the Maiden's Feast system. Yeah, cupcakes against lies.
What exactly are the lies of the Maiden's Feast system?
They told us that we had to offer maidens as a sacrifice to save our village. And we just went along with it because that's how it's always been done. Yeah, us too. But we were all lied to.
Yes. Yes, we were.
See, Rocky? I told you it'd be easy to convince people.
Why is it only maidens who are sacrificed?
Great question. Thank you. We have a lot of questions just like that.
So you're going to get rid of the whole system?
One cupcake at a time. Each one is like a question. We go from town to town, selling cupcakes, asking questions. Until it's like a giant snowball of cupcakes and questions, rolling on and getting bigger and bigger. Until it's big enough to take down a whole Mog itself.
Wow.
Yeah, but, you know, we gotta start small.
Where are your parents?
Well, my dad is in my mom's cloud shoe hut, getting parenting lessons from Rocky's old man. And my mom's trying to cheer up another victim of the Maiden's Feast we met. A girl my sister's age. And I'm not supposed to tell anyone where my mom is, but I know. Let's just say she's catching dinner.
Well, bye. Good luck with the bake sale.
Missing Persons Awareness Campaign and Revolution by way of cupcakes.
That's what I said.
Okay, old man. This time, you're going down. How'd you do that?
Say there. Do you guys know any place around here to get some money?
Oh, I have lots of money. My dad says it's important to give it away. You want some?
Just enough to buy a cupcake.
Here you go.
Thanks. Why do you have so much?
Well, Pops gives it to me to give to Harmony. But I know Harmony likes to stay light, so I keep most of it myself to lighten his burden.
That'll never hold up in court.
Somehow, I think you're going to end up the hero of your family.
I know! Because I'm a warrior!
Why are you beating up this little kid?
Not teaching him how to fight!
I'm on lesson 5.
He begged me.
What are you guys doing all the way out here?
We needed to find a place far away from everybody. Some people don't like to see an old man beating up on a little kid.
Or the other way around.
Uh-huh.
Did you guys see that bake sale over there?
Yep. Frosted them cakes myself. Fastest gun in the West. Almost out of the redstone. Well, I got enough for one more cake. I better save it. I want to make sure I have enough to make one for Bella when we find her.
You frosted all of those cupcakes by yourself?
I can't help it. To see a blank cupcake, just have to frost it. I'm against this whole baker thing, but if we're gonna do it, then I'm gonna be the best at it.
Like me, with fighting!
Do you really need that cane? You seem pretty light on your feet.
Well, I do seem to have a lot more get up and go, now that Bella's inspired me. Seeing her kick that fog right in its soft bits really put the fight back in my bones. But I still need the cane. It's where I keep my frosting.
Okay, back to your lessons.
On your feet, soldier!
I am!
Oh.
Such amazing fauna on this planet. I mean, place. Stay there.
Huh?
Okay.
Hey, hey! You want to buy a cupcake?
Hey, can I buy one of those cupcakes? I got money.
Great! I will take that money. Here's your cupcake. The red frosting is special. It was her favorite kind. Well, actually, it's my favorite kind. But I never let her have any before. And now she's gone, so now I wish I could.
Hey, Rocky, it's okay. We're going to find her. You know, she's probably out beating up some poor Mog right now.
That is most definitely true. Thanks for the cupcake.
It's a fundraiser.
It's got that girl on top, Bella. Except she looks... I don't like to eat things with faces.
Tell him, Rocky.
Spoon, shall we eat this cupcake?
Sir, even I, who believe spoons can do anything, wonder what kind of monster would eat a cupcake with a spoon.
Yes, so whenever you're ready for some cupcakes for a good cause, we'll be right...
What happened to this place?
Haven't you ever been to the Maiden's Feast?
I want to say no, but I'm worried the answer is yes.
Do you know this guy?
No one should ever have to go to a Maiden's Feast. And no one ever will again, if I can have anything to do with it.
I'm cool with that.
What exactly is a Maiden's Feast?
Something we've always had to do. So we were told, and we believed it. We thought it a great honor. We were so happy for Vella. So proud of her. So foolish.
So, Maiden's Feasts are bad then?
My daughter taught us that when she fought the monster. You see, it didn't destroy the town. It just ran away. She was right the whole time, all those years. All those girls. For nothing.
I'm not sure if you want to hear this, Morelia, but you're actually cheering me up right now.
Is there anything I can do to help?
I just want to find my daughter. To
beg her forgiveness and tell her how proud of her I am.
Please, please be my mother.
What were you guys talking about when I walked up?
I was just trying to cheer up this young lady here.
But she's just starting to realize what a loser I am.
You are not.
Then why didn't Mogchothra pick me?
Well, I'm not sure, honey.
I can't think of any reason that sounds sane.
Who are you again?
My name is Shay. I'm not from here.
Listen, Twyla. It's time to move on.
And do what? The Maiden's Feast is the only thing I've prepared for all my life.
Well, I'm sure you're good at lots of other things. Like, let me think.
Swinging?
You making fun of me?
Well, at least your costume is cool.
Oh, thanks. Made it myself.
You made that stunning dress by yourself? That's amazing, Twyla.
Meh. Fat lot of good it did me.
Do you think you could make me a costume?
Huh?
Oh, I think that would be a great thing for you to do, Twyla.
Well, maybe if you had a pattern and some material, maybe I could whip something up.
Okay, I'll get a pattern and the material and be right back.
Oh, exciting.
So, can you make me one of those?
Oh, that's adorable. How old is your baby?
Oh, it's for me. I need it a little bigger.
Well, I suppose I could use this for a reference.
There's my can-do gal.
Just get me the material you want for your giant baby onesie and we're good to go.
It's not a... Oh, never mind. Be right back with the material.
Uh-huh. You think you're gonna save it? Well...
Better not move it. I don't want to... That egg looks like it's having a little trouble hatching. Maybe I should... Uh-oh.
Oh!
Ow.
Okay.
We'll return in time. Let our child rise from its rotten bed.
Hey, are you those guards who stole Alex's radiation-proof curtains?
Without admitting any wrongdoing.
What's it to ya?
If you give me back those robes, I promise Alex won't press charges.
First of all, we didn't steal anything.
Secondly, we're naked under here, so no way you're getting our robes.
If you want them, you're gonna have to fight us for them.
I'll fight you for those robes, no problem. I need them to help my mom.
Oh, that's so sweet. He wants to help his mother.
And he's willing to beat us up with a stick to do it.
No, I'm not going to beat anybody up. But I will easily disarm the both of you. I've completed several fencing missions with my yarn pals, so if you have another stick handy...
We don't have any fencing sticks handy, Mr. Fancy.
But if you find one, feel free to come back and try to take our robes from us.
Are you guys looking for a tree to talk to? Because I saw one down in the forest that might actually talk back.
Oh, no thanks. We know that weirdo.
We're here because this is the tree with the fruit.
The fruit, that is, the answer.
That was really convincing, Courtney.
Thanks. I did the pause just like you said.
What are you guys doing up here?
We are the former Dead-Eyed Druids.
Misled and betrayed by a false prophet, we have come to seek wisdom from the Tree of Answers.
Why do you think this tree has answers?
Okay, honestly, it wasn't our first choice.
We really came up here because we heard about this guru of lightness that a lot of people were following.
But apparently he's out of commission. So we remembered this fruit, and since it was the answer to the riddle of Yorn,
maybe it's the answer to everything.
Just because the fruit was the answer to one riddle.
Too many questions.
This is a matter of faith.
Also, we really need this to work because we've run out of stuff to believe in.
Yeah, we're kind of at the end of our ropes.
I'm going to get a stick, and then we're going to fight for those robes.
Why don't you go get some yarn instead?
Yeah, we'd love to meet one of your friends.
I'll be back.
Yeah, that's what the Dead-Eye God said. Up from a hidden pit.
Long after we are dead.
Not good.
Wait, are we speaking as us?
Mind if I take one of these?
Please, spread the word. We might just save some lives here, man.
How's the fruit?
It's a little on the tangy side, to be honest, but you know, the game is always sweetest to the hunter.
So, what kind of hunter are you?
I've been trying to get this fruit all day, but I had some issues, and I almost gave up. But I went to the arcade and beat my own high score on 3D Hypercrypt, and I was like, if I can do that, I can do anything, you know?
Of course. Everyone knows video games are good for your self-esteem. What's that thing you're sticking in the fruit?
Oh, this little tapper thing? That's so I can skip all the skin and fiber and just drink the juice right away. Juice, you know? That way all the phytonutrients and stuff get in your bloodstream faster. For when you want to get healthy in a big hurry, man.
What's the big healthy rush?
Well, recently I was all hung up on my own on my underlying issues, and I had some time to think. And then this girl hit me. It hit me. I need to turn my life around. Then I got that high score at the arcade, and now here I am, the king of health!
So why are you going to turn your life around?
Well, at first, it was because of this girl, McGee. I imagined her cheering me on through each level in 3D Hypercrypt. But then when I reached the end, I realized McGee doesn't care about 3D Hypercrypt.
She doesn't play video games.
No, she thinks the 3D is a gimmick. She only plays the original. But what I'm saying is that the high score, the juicing, it's okay if it's just for me. I'm not doing this to impress anybody, you know?
That's good. Drinking all that juice, don't you have to use the bathroom a lot?
I'll let you in on a little secret. When you live in the clouds, you're never very far from a bathroom.
Oh, there are people down below. I was just down below.
Hey, watch the skies, man.
So how are you going to turn your life around?
Well, like, what's the next step from here? Probably go back to the arcade, you know, and look for another sign. Lots of other high scores to beat, man.
Hey, can I borrow that little fruit tapper?
Yeah, actually, I've been thinking the acid or something in the fruit is messing with the coating on this thing and giving it a weird taste. You can have it. I'll just squeeze it out natural.
Thanks.
Don't worry. I don't have a cold or anything.
I'll let you get back to your juice.
Bye.
It's that little tapper the hunter guy gave me. I might try that if it were the filled kind. It's that little tapper the hunter guy gave me.
Worshipping the tree.
You guys want some fruit?
We can't eat it now that we worship it. At least we think that's one of the rules. We're still kind of making it up as we go. Maybe we're the child. Or the rotten fence. You know what part of this story I really feel like, Dawn? What
question? Uh-oh.
The pit.
Build a fountain for that weirdo? Or is this some kind of warning about him? Hey, maybe a hook would help.
I've already hooked my ladder onto his cloud. I'm just afraid to climb it.
I can't do that from here. Psst, Father.
Hello?
Let's give that knot another... Just... Psst, Father. Let's give that knot... Just tug on different parts.
Yep. Rats, that was a bad idea.
What does it look like now?
Well, like a whole new, terrible knot.
Psst, Father.
Hello?
Let's give that knot another... Just tug on different...